Hello everyone, Mike here on the Constant Creative DeadX Constant Creative server with a very quick plot update and a contest. Kind of a contest. You could call it a contest. So, new stuff, as far as I can remember, is of course the corporate headquarters. So that's got all the businesses, so that's taken care of. There's Wendy's house. She decided to make something a little bit bigger. Then she made one that's too small, and then made one that's very big. But this is the middle of the town, so that's okay. All the big stuff goes kind of in the middle. This plot here, well, that's what we're asking about. So right here, this is the coffee house. This one here, they sell coffee and donuts and things. This is the theater, movie theater. Get to that in a minute. But this video is mainly about these three plots. So I'm looking for a house that's, or a build of some kind, that's 14 by 14 or 16 by 16. The leaves that surround it make it 16 by 16. With a maximum height of 10 or 15 blocks. 10 to 15 blocks, including the roof, so not too high. And the lucky three people, I'm looking for three different people who submit some buildings, who get accepted, I will be doing a video tour of any plot on the server of their choosing, whether it be their plot, or server spawn, or something really stupid. I'll do it. That's what you win. And I'll read off some topics. You can send me some topics to discuss. History of it, you know, a bit about who you are and how you became a Minecraft player and whatnot, if you like. And that's it. That's what I made this video for. While I'm here, I'll just show you a few things that are new. The theater, I don't know if anyone's seen the theater yet. This is Dallas's creation. I, of course, did a little redstoning around here, like the switch track and whatever. But essentially, this is Dallas's creation. I'm just going to turn on the block sounds effects here. So here's the theater. There's Attack of the Brain Dead Zombies, Anvil of Dawn, Captain Planet the Movie, Art, Fact or Over Imagination, and Honey, I Shrunk a Head. Movie posters. Hey, a punny play by his forever girl. Then we have Fashion and Fame, Jim and the Holograms biography, if anyone knows that show from the 80s or 90s. Eat Your Greens, a documentary of trees. That's right. So over here we have, this is the condiments after you get your popcorn at the front desk here. It's condiments. We have extra butter, dill seasoning, and ketchup or spicy seasoning. Like that one. Over here they sell cookies, cake, and watermelon. And you can buy popcorn, cola, chips, candies. Unfortunately, you can't buy baked beans. They're all sold out. That was a very popular thing in movie theaters. From the inside, it's just for looks. There's a popcorn machine there. It's just glass and sandstone. Then we have some pop dispensers. Right? And then, of course, the candy comes from down here. The movie theater has a special door. You place any item in the hopper, and you wait about 5 seconds for it to be accepted. There it goes. And the door opens. And once you pass through, the door will close immediately after you. So this is how you can pay to get in. You know, the cashier has to ring through, and they may be on their cell phone or something. So you go down into the theater. These side lights, these were totally by accident. It's just a glitch with putting light next to a half slab or stairs, but they work beautifully. So you go down here, and there is a 3D movie playing in the theater. We have some torches going down the sides. There's the projector up there. The projector doesn't look like it's on, but I guess it's using a special bulb that doesn't give off too much light. The stairs are made of two different textures, because when you put the same texture all together, it just looks like a bench or a bunch of stairs. So this way, it shows that there are 5 seats in this row, in each row. Then you go down, and there's a 3D movie playing. Oh, the 3D technology has gotten so well that it looks like the theater itself is 3D. It is Steve. Steve has found some diamonds, and he's going to mine those diamonds. Unluckily for Steve, there is a creeper and a skeleton waiting just behind him with the possibility of losing everything in the lava. So what will happen next, I wonder? Boy, exciting. Once your movie's over, or if you have to go to the bathroom, unfortunately there's no theater in here, so you'll have to go back to your home. You go up to the stairs on the left. There's a glitch in Minecraft where if you're on Soul Sand, and there is a ledge above the step that you're trying to step to, because you're on Soul Sand, it will not let you pass there. You got to kind of jump and... See, you can't even... It's very difficult to get through. And so this creates a one-way door so that you can't get down unless you pay. Pretty cool. And that's it. That's the movie theater. I think that's really the only new thing. I've recently acquisitioned this plot next to me. So I'll be expanding the town further into that area. Either a camping ground or... Maybe I'll just move the military base over there and make a bunch of Command & Conquer stuff. Who knows? Who knows? The next plot after that is a bunch of military-style vehicles and a really nice large wooden house. So either one would work. A campsite or military base would work either way. Or maybe I'll just use it for testing stuff. That's it. Thank you for watching. This is also new. Here's a house that I made. It's just one of my houses. You've seen my houses. They're small and they're compact and stuff. I think I already went through this house, actually. I may be repeating myself. Who knows? Thank you for watching. And you have yourselves a pleasant day. And here's hoping for the best next three houses on the plot. Good night. Or good day. Good morning. Toodles.